One evening, Sir Topham Hatt came to Tidmouth Sheds to introduce the engines back to Mr. Conductor. However, Percy wasn't paying attention too much. "Percy, are you okay?" asked Toby.
"It's the same every day," he said. "Sometimes I'll pull a passenger train, maybe shunt a few trucks in the yard, pull some milk tankers, then the nightly mail run, then go back to the sheds. It's the same every day."
"Better suck it up," said Thomas. "I pull Annie and Clarabelle non-stop every day, with no other variation. Sometimes I pull some trucks, though."
"Now, Thomas, it can be a bit boring and tedious working on the Farquhar branch line. How about you pick this up with Sir Topham Hatt, Percy?" said Toby.
"Okay, I'll do that tomorrow morning," said Percy.
The next morning, before reporting to work, Percy bumped into the yards to speak with Sir Topham Hatt and Mr. Conductor.
"Sir, it's been the same every day," he said.
"I know, Percy. I overheard your conversation last night with Thomas and Toby, and I have plans to relocate you to the Little Western branch line."
"Really? Oh, thank you, sir. That'll be a nice change in scenery."
"Get a move on, Percy."
"All right, I'm going, James."
Soon, Percy puffed into the yard at the Little Western branch line.
"Hello, Percy," said Duck. "I'm glad you're back. We could sure use the help around here."
"Yes," said Oliver, "as the summer traffic is finally coming in."
"Well then," said Percy, "let's get right to work."
"I like his attitude," said Duck.
Duck and Oliver followed Percy. For the rest of the day, Percy worked very diligently on the Little Western branch line, and the other engines were quite impressed with his hard-working attitude.
"We're glad we have him in our yard," said Douglas.
"Aye," said Donald, "certainly is a hard worker. Otherwise, we will be up to our eyes in goods and passenger traffic."
However, the engines on the Farquhar branch line weren't so happy. Percy did a lot of the work, and without him, the engines over on the Farquhar branch line rubbed their eyes and they got no rest. It showed. Thomas and Toby consulted, decided that the best solution would be to ask Percy to come back to the Farquhar branch line. And so they did so.
"Percy, please come back," said Thomas and Toby. "We really miss you, and you were a vital part of the branch line, so we're quite exhausted."
"Sorry," said Percy, "but I like life here on the Little Western much better."
"Okay," said Thomas, "time to pick this up with Sir Topham Hatt. We need a new engine." Soon, Thomas and Toby came to Sir Topham Hatt and Mr. Conductor. Mr. Conductor was now Sir Topham Hatt's new assistant.
"Sir," said Thomas, "we really miss Percy, as he worked really hard."
"Well," said Sir Topham Hatt, "I notice that you two have been working a lot, and have even been overworking lately. So, Rosie is going to be coming back very soon."
"Oh, really?" said Toby. "Thank you so much, sir."
"We missed her dearly," said Toby.
And Thomas and Toby smiled at each other, knowing that a friend is coming back.